Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free complete course for the CCNA. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. If you want more labs like this, I highly recommend Boson Software's NetSim for CCNA. NetSim is a network simulator like Packet Tracer, but it's far more powerful and contains over 100 detailed guided labs covering the CCNA exam topics. If you want to get NetSim, follow the link in the description. In this video, we'll configure port security on Switch 1 and Switch 2. We'll configure it on Switch 1's interfaces connected to the PCs, and on Switch 2's G01 interface connected to Switch 1. Some of the commands I introduced in the lecture video aren't supported in Packet Tracer, but the most important ones are. So, first let's configure Switch 1. On the F01, 2, and 3 interfaces, we'll enable port security with the shutdown mode, one MAC address allowed, sticky learning disabled, and an aging time of 1 hour. Enable conft. The port security configuration of each interface will be the same. So let's do interface range F01 to 3. By default, the violation mode is shutdown, and the maximum number of MAC addresses allowed is also 1. Sticky MAC address learning is also disabled by default, so we don't have to configure any of those. Let's just set the aging time to 1 hour. With the default time of 0 minutes, secure MAC addresses will never age out. Switch port security aging time, and then enter the time in minutes, 60. Now, port security itself isn't actually enabled yet, so I'll enable it. Switch port security. But the command is rejected, a common mistake when configuring port security. These interfaces have the default administrative mode of dynamic auto. Let's check one of them. Do show interfaces F01 switch port. Up here you can see it, administrative mode, dynamic auto. To enable port security, the interface must be manually configured as an access port or trunk port. So, switch port mode access. Now let's try again. Switch port port security. Okay, it should be enabled. I'll check one of the interfaces. Do show port security interface F01. Okay, port security is enabled, and the default setting of the violation mode is shut down. The aging time of 60 minutes I configured is shown here. That's all we need to configure on Switch 1. So let's move on to Switch 2. We'll configure port security on G01 with the restrict violation mode, a maximum of 4 addresses, and sticky MAC address learning enabled. Why 4 addresses, even though there are only 3 PCs in the network currently? It's because Switch 2 will be receiving CDP messages from Switch 1, so it will learn Switch 1's MAC address too. Okay, let's configure it. Enable conft interface G01. The default port security violation mode is shutdown, so let's configure restrict mode. Switch port security, violation, restrict. And then the maximum number of addresses. Switch port security maximum, 4. And then enable sticky MAC address learning. Switch port security, MAC address sticky. Finally, let's enable port security. There is only one VLAN in the network, VLAN 1, so I'll just configure G01 as an access port, although trunk is an option too. Switch port mode access. Now I'll enable port security. Switch port security. Okay, let's check those settings. Do show port security, interface G01. Okay, port security is enabled, the violation mode is restrict, and the maximum number of addresses is 4. As for sticky learning, we'll test that now. I'll ping from each PC to R1, so that Switch 1 and Switch 2 can learn their MAC addresses. PC 1 first. Ping 10.0.0.254. Okay, then PC 2. Ping 10.0.0.254. And finally, PC 3. Ping 10.0.0.254. Okay, now let's check on switch 2. Do show port security interface G01. So the total MAC addresses learned is 4, PCs 1, 2, 3, and switch 1. And all 4 of those MAC addresses are sticky. Let's check the config of G01. Do show run. Scroll down to G01, and here we can see the MAC addresses of PC1, PC2, PC3, and this one here must be switch 1. And let's check the MAC address table. Do show MAC address table. Okay, there are the same 4 MAC addresses. Notice the type of static, even though they were dynamically learned. That's because of sticky learning. And one more command. Do show port security. So G01 has a maximum of 4 secure MAC addresses. It currently has learned 4. There are 0 security violations, and the security action is restrict. Now let's trigger some violations and see what happens. First, I'll trigger a violation on switch 2. To do that, I'll go on switch 1 and configure the VLAN 1 SVI. Interface VLAN 1. IP address 10.0.0.10 255.255.255.0. No shutdown. Okay, so if switch 1 tries to ping R1, the source MAC address will be the MAC address of the VLAN 1 SVI. Switch 2 learned the MAC address of switch 1's G01 interface, but it doesn't know the MAC address of the VLAN 1 SVI. So let's try that ping. Do ping 10.0.0.254. Okay, the ping isn't working. That's because switch 2 is blocking the pings because of the unauthorized source MAC address. Let's check on switch 2. Do show port security interface G01. Okay, notice the port status is still secure up, but the violation counter has been incremented. There haven't been any syslog messages. That might be an issue with Packet Tracer. By default, a syslog message should be displayed in the console. Anyway, that's the restrict mode. Now let's trigger a violation on switch 1. To do that, I'll change the MAC address of PC1. To do that in Packet Tracer, go to the config tab of PC1, click on Fast Ethernet 0, and then change the MAC address here. I'll change the last 1 to an A, and let's try to ping R1. Ping 10.0.0.254. Okay, it doesn't work this time. Let's take a look on switch 1. Okay, here, syslog messages have been shown for the F01 interface being shut down, but no actual port security related syslog messages. Anyway, let's check the interface. Do show port security interface F01. Okay, the state is secure shutdown, and the security violation count is 1. Now, air disable recovery isn't available in Packet Tracer, so if you want to re-enable the interface, you'll need to do it manually. Anyway, in this lab, we did some basic port security configurations and observed how the shutdown and restrict violation modes work. That's all for this lab. Next, let's take a look at a bonus lab in Boson Software's NetSim for CCNA. Okay, here's today's Boson NetSim practice lab. The lab I have selected is Troubleshooting Port Security. So let's check it out. It's a pretty simple topology. One PC connected to a switch connected to a router. So the PC is connected to Fast Ethernet 02, make note of that. And the router is connected to the Fast Ethernet 01 interface of the switch. Okay, so a username of Boson and password of Cisco are configured on switch 1, okay. And task 1 is to verify the port security configuration. So port security has been configured on the port that connects switch 1 to PC1. So that was Fast Ethernet 02. However, PC1 can no longer connect to the network. Okay. So task 1. From PC1, attempt to ping router 4. Okay, let's try that. Okay, it looks like the ping is not working. Yep, it is not. Okay, on PC1, issue the ipconfig/all command. Is PC1 configured with a correct IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway? And what is PC1's MAC address? Okay, so ipconfig/all. The IP address 192.168.1.252, that's correct, /24, prefix length. And the default gateway is router 4, so that looks correct. The MAC address is this physical address here. So let's just remember the last four digits, 2251. That's the MAC address. Okay, on switch 1, display the current port security settings for the switch. Which port has been configured with port security? Okay, Boson, Cisco. Okay, show. I'll just check the running config. So yes, Fast Ethernet 02 is enabled with port security. This is the MAC address configured on the interface. That is not PC1's. Let's check port security. Show port security. Yep, Fast Ethernet 02. One maximum address. One current address, and that was manually configured, we saw earlier. Security violation, shut down, yep. And the action is shut down. Okay, on switch 1, display the current port security settings specifically for Fast Ethernet 02. What is the current status? What happens when more than the maximum number of MAC addresses attempt to connect to the Fast Ethernet 02 port? Okay, show port security, interface, F02. It is enabled, but the status is secure shutdown. So it does have a violation. And what happens when more than the maximum number of MAC addresses attempt to connect? That is shutdown. Okay, what other port security violation modes can be configured on a switch interface? Okay, so there are shutdown, restrict, and protect, those three. On switch 1, display statistics and information about the Fast Ethernet 02 interface. Statistics and information, are they referring to show interface F02? This is probably it. What do you notice about the state of the interface? I notice that it is error disabled because of that shutdown violation mode. Display the running configuration. Okay, I already did that. But let's look at it again. Here it is. What MAC address is allowed? Well, it's this one, but that is not PC1's MAC address. Based on the information you have gathered so far, why is PC1 not able to ping router 4? Well, that's because the MAC address configured here is not PC1's MAC address. Okay, on switch 1, shut down the Fast Ethernet 02 interface. Why should you shut down an interface that has entered the error disabled state? Well, that's because in order to re-enable it, you have to shut it down first. So, conf t, interface F02, shut down. And let's remove that incorrect MAC address. Oh, and that is actually router 4's MAC address. Interesting. Okay, so I will copy that. Oops. Okay, paste that in there. Oh, it looks like I pasted that a few too many times. Right click to paste. There we go. Control A to go to the beginning of the line. No. Okay, and that deletes it. So now I will right click one more time, get rid of this MAC address, and enter PC1's. It shows PC1's up here in the instructions. Let's see if that's correct. Yes, it is. Okay. So 000C7988-2251. There we go. And then enable the interface, no shutdown. And let's try that ping. Actually, there might be spanning tree. Show spanning tree. Okay, nope. It is already forwarding. So let's try that ping. Ping 192.168.1.1. And it works. Perfect. Let's check that. Here we go. Show port security interface F02. So the last source address is PC1's MAC address, security violation count 0, total MAC address is 1. So that is PC1's MAC address. Okay, so that is all for today's Boson NetSim Practice Lab. The lab solutions are available down here. So if you are ever confused or don't know what to do in the step, you can always check the answers down here. And you can see they give explanations about each of the steps you have to do. And you can also use the grade lab function, which is this button here, grade lab, and it will check the configurations and make sure that everything is correct. So we configured switch 1, and you can see there are no lines in red, so that means all of the configurations are correct. This one here, PC1's MAC address. Okay, so if you want to get Boson NetSim, please follow the link in the video description. Before finishing today's video, I want to thank my JCNP level channel members. To join, please click the Join button under the video. Thank you to Tom, Samil, Seamode, Scott, Martin, Kwa, Christopher, Tebogo, Anand, Pavel, Abraham, Sergey, Unjoku, Victor, Roger, Suki, Kenneth, Seamus, Brandon, Marcel, Kone, Donald, Gustavo, Prakash, Nasir, Erlison, Marco, Daming, Ed, John, Funny Dart, Velva Jacob, Mark, Yusuf, Boson Software, Devin, Jonathan, and Vance. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. This is the list of JCNP level members at the time of recording, by the way, May 31st, 2021. If you signed up recently and your name isn't on here, don't worry, you'll be in future videos. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave verified publisher and accept BAT or Basic Attention Token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.